Configuring a universal test machine can be challenging. There are a lot of options and a lot of choices to make. Sometimes the right system is obvious, or you might have to make some trade-offs based on budget and future test requirements, which may not be clear. In this video, we are going to show you how to quickly zero in on your test system. Following a few simple steps, you can have the confidence that your system will allow you to perform the tests you need today and be prepared for more tests tomorrow. We also recommend that before you buy, talk to one of our applications engineers. Just another set of eyes on your situation. Our experience makes it clear that it is always worthwhile to spend a little time up front.
Universal test machines perform a wide variety of test types that are based on the machine's ability to produce tension and compression loads and motions. Using interchangeable fixtures, our UTMs can be configured to perform tensile, compression, bend or flex, tear, peel, cyclic, shear, and many other tests. In fact, we have identified over 1,000 different ASTM or ISO tests that your test resources machine can perform. They can be used to test materials and components in a lab or production test environment. Our goal is to help you configure a system that works for you now and the foreseeable future, and at the same time, that you not spend any more on a system than you need to. Our first and most important step is to identify the load frame that meets your long-term force requirements. Frame capacity affects price more than any other part of the system. Generally speaking, the higher the load rating, the higher the price. So if you think there's a reasonable chance you will need to test a force that requires a larger load frame, we always recommend getting the larger frame. The additional cost is marginal now, but later if you need to buy another frame, it will be significant, and nobody wants that to happen. Step 2, know your test space requirements. The selected frame must also provide the test space to accommodate your largest test specimen, the test fixtures, any environmental chambers or baths, and the crosshead travel needed to set up and run the test. Also, the crosshead must have enough travel to stretch the test sample to its ultimate elongation. Step 3. Consider all the different tests and capabilities of your future test operators. If you regularly perform a limited number of the same standard tests, then consider our computerized digital touchpad that combines affordability with simplicity. In some situations, less really is more. On the other hand, if you find it difficult to anticipate your future test requirements, and you have multiple operators who want the freedom of setting up their own tests, then consider our controller, which is capable of making the machine do virtually any mechanical test. Follow these 3 steps, and you will be in the right ballpark for selecting your system. But I really want to emphasize, based on our experience with thousands of applications, that you talk with one of our applications engineers. We regularly find that during our phone calls, some key issues is discovered and resolved, saving a great deal of frustration and expense later on. And now with one more comment, back to Sean.
We also have a tip sheet that will help you walk through these steps that we have discovered over the years of specifying systems. To get the tip sheet, click the link or go to our website. Thank you for watching.